Hello, friends. This is Pastor Willard, and I'm coming to you to hopefully provide a bit of a perspective about the leadership structure at Pikeville United Methodist Church. In the fall of 2019, we approved a change in our leadership structure. The Book of Discipline from 1996 gave us the permission to do that, but up until 2019, we were continuing to use the same structure that had previously been put into place. So here's what the changes that we made in 2019 look like, because we've really not had the opportunity recently to discuss this. It might be helpful for you to know this information. First of all, we have two bodies that we're primarily going to talk about today. The first is the Administrative Ministries Team, and the second is the Church Council. And I want to go through just a bit on both of those groups, and we're going to start with the Administrative Ministries Team. First of all, the Administrative Ministries Team is exactly what it sounds like. Their responsibility is to oversee the administration of the church. And they do that by combining what was at one time three separate groups into one body. That's the Staff Parish Relations Committee, known as the SPRC, the Trustees, and the Finance Team. And they are joined in their work by a group of people who, by virtue of their office, ex officio, are given positions on these bodies by the Book of Discipline. So we're not doing anything really that the church hasn't already granted us permission to do. The Staff Parish Relations Committee is responsible for being the liaison between the Kentucky Annual Conference and Pikeville United Methodist Church for the pastors, Pastor Chris and myself. But it also serves as the oversight body of the entirety of our staff. They set the salaries, they come up with the job descriptions. That's their responsibility, Staff Parish Relations Committee. The trustees are the legal body of the church. They oversee our property primarily, but they have the legal responsibility to carry out the wishes of the church and to represent the church. So for instance, if we were to buy a building of some sort, strictly hypothetical, relaxed, no one's thinking it, they would be the ones who would have to sign for that. They would be the ones who would have to vote to approve that. And then the finance team is exactly what it sounds like. They recommend the annual budget, they oversee the expenditures of the church, and they have the responsibility to carry out day-to-day the financial aspects of our life together as a church. The ex officio members are people like our delegates to annual conference. We have two. Because there are two pastors appointed by the bishop to this church, we have two delegates to annual conference. We have a lay leader, and we have a church council chair, and we'll say just a little bit more about that in a few moments. So the Administrative Ministries team meets on the fourth, will be starting in August, meeting on the fourth Sunday of every month. Here previously, we've been meeting on the third Sunday of the month. This group functioned during the COVID challenge. They met for a year exclusively via Zoom. They had their first face-to-face sit-down meeting this past week, and they've done a wonderful job. Again, monthly meetings, they are responsible for day-to-day carrying out the smaller picture of our church life together. Property, personnel, property, and finance. That's their responsibility. I want to talk primarily, though, about the church council, and that's this body here, and that's why we're making this video tonight, because there's been some confusion about the difference between the two. The Administrative Ministries team basically does the work that had been done in the past by these three groups, SPRC, trustees, and finance, but the church council does the work that in the past had been done by what we call the board, the administrative board of the church. It is comprised of the chairs of these different teams. The leader of the Administrative Ministries team, Mary Moore, Staff Parish, Pamela Gillum, Trustees, Rick Dameron, Finance, Donna Cassell. So those folks have a place on the church council. That's actually mandated by the Book of Discipline. And then we have seven program ministry team leaders, because we wanted to make this more about ministry and less about administration. So our ministry teams, our prayer team, our evangelism team, our congregational care team, which at the moment does not have a team leader, our missions team, our communication team, our fellowship team, and our spiritual the spiritual formation team are represented on this body. The age level leaders, children, youth, and young adults are represented at this body. Then we have a couple of other groups that are somewhat unique in that we have a preschool here at this church, Genesis Kids Preschool, and their chair is a part of the church council. Also, the United Methodist Women have a representative on the church council. We have at-large members. These are folks who are approved by our church as representing the church as a whole. In other words, we may look over this list of folks from this part up and go, you know, there's some holes in this list. We don't necessarily have enough voices represented. And so we select a few folks to be at-large members. And then again, the ex officio members who are a part of this team are the same ones who are on the administrative ministries team. This also includes Pastor Chris and myself as staff members, pastors under appointment. We are a part of this body as well. This group meets on a quarterly basis. That was the way we established it in the fall of 2019 when we approved this structure. But we've not had a regularly scheduled quarterly meeting. We were preparing to do that in 2020 when COVID hit. Instead, this body has the church council, the board, as we used to call it, has had to make some very difficult decisions in special called sessions by Zoom. Those have been challenging. And so this group is going to regularly meet on a quarterly basis, but it can meet as needed. And the difference between the administrative ministries team and the church council is that while the administrative ministry team is focused on the day-to-day operation of the church, this body is a bigger picture. Think of this as the group that sets and plots the direction of the church that the administrative ministries team then is responsible to help carry out. So for instance, the finance committee of the administrative ministries team will prepare a budget and recommend a budget, but that has to be approved by the church council. The administrative ministries team will recommend salaries for Pastor Chris and for me each year, but again, the church council has to approve it. The nominating committee of the church, as we previously and historically called it, will bring a set of officers present, but the church council has to approve that. So this is the bigger picture body, the church council. If the church needed to do something, quite frankly, drastic, for lack of a better word, if there were a major catastrophe, God forbid, and we had to do something drastic, this would be the body that we would speak with. The administrative ministries team has the authority to carry out everything that's been approved by the church council. Once the budget is set, once the staff has been hired, these folks oversee the responsibilities. So if there's a repair that has to be made, the trustees handle it. We don't take that to the church council unless it exceeds what we have in the budget to do so. So hopefully this has helped clear things up. July the 26th, this coming Monday night, we're going to have a church council meeting, and it's our first one. So here's what's coming to you by email. You're going to get an agenda for the meeting. You're going to get a copy of a report to fill out. Those of you who have that responsibility, the administrative ministry team leaders, the program ministry team leaders, the age level leaders, and the other group leaders are going to be asked to just complete a simple one-page report. Essentially, what have you done since January 1 in this area of ministry? Now relax. I know we've not had the opportunity to do the things that we would normally do. We understand that. This first meeting is really about trying to establish a pattern that we're going to do in the future. So don't feel like, because if you've got nothing to report, just simply write, we don't have anything to report. And send that back to the church office so that those could be collected together in one body, in one packet, and then sent out to everyone so they can see it in advance of the meeting, so we don't have to spend all of the meeting hearing from each group what you've already done. We can write that down. What we want to focus on in the meeting of the church council that's coming up on Monday night is, what are you going to do between now and the end of September, the third quarter of the year, as it comes to an end? So for instance, let's pick on children's ministry, for instance, and we'll just say hypothetically, What have you done since January 1? That's a question on the report sheet. But what are you going to do between now and September 30th? And if you've got dates, please let us know so that we can get those on the church calendar and we can work together and make sure that nothing comes as a surprise to anyone. Now, hopefully, what we would like to do then is we move into next year, early next year, probably mid to late January, what we would like to do is have a retreat time, a weekend retreat, like we've done the last couple of years, and bring all of these folks together and anybody else who wants to come from the church and say, what is it that the Holy Spirit of God wants us to do in the year 2022? And then each quarter, this group comes together to mark our progress. How are we doing? Now, maybe what we decide is we may have heard God wrong about something and we need to make a mid-course correction. Or something occurs that we weren't anticipating at all. We've got to make a major decision. This body's in place to do that. And you, hopefully, will be able to be a part of it. We're excited about the future. Yes, COVID challenged us in terms of implementing this, but we think this is a good plan and it's a good way to live into our future, God's preferred future for Pikeville United Methodist Church. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Have a great day. See you Sunday or Monday.